As I'm sure you already know, OBS Studio is one of the most versatile pieces of streaming software there is, but it's also a recording powerhouse, and I use it to record just about everything. Setting up OBS Studio for recording is very similar to setting it up for streaming, with a few minor tweaks. I'm Dwayne Burke, here to help make OBS Studio less scary and more fun. And welcome back to my tutorial course. If at any point you find this video helpful, consider dropping a like and subscribing to the channel with notifications on so you can find your way back for more information about OBS Studio and live streaming. The entire course is linked in the playlist in the video description. And if your question isn't answered here in this video, check there. Just like with your streaming settings, to maximize the potential of your recording, make sure the output tab of your settings is set to advanced. This will allow you to optimize settings for your hardware configuration. Then click the recording tab. The streaming and recording settings are completely independent. So if you're setting up a profile exclusively for recording, you can ignore the streaming tab. Within the recording tab, the setting that is the most difficult to fine-tune for your setup is bitrate. The bitrate is the rate at which data is recorded for the video file. In general, more bitrate equals higher quality, but it does have a ceiling. Also, with more bitrate comes larger file sizes and possibly the need for additional storage or a drive dedicated to recording. Now, let's actually get into the settings. For type, just leave this on the standard. In a future lesson, I will cover some of the specific use cases for custom, but most of you only need to use standard. The recording path is wherever you want your video recordings to be saved. If you ever forget where you save your recordings, you can always come back and check here. You'll get the best recording performance if you can record to a secondary hard drive or solid state drive in your computer. If you don't have that option, it's not a big deal. Your records will still be fine. Next, we've got recording format. More people will want to choose MP4 or MKV. MP4 is the most widely compatible video format, but it is prone to corruption. MKV does not corrupt, but it is not compatible with most editing software. Once you're done recording, you'll have to remix the recording by going to File, Remux Recordings, or Set Recordings to Automatically Remux to MP4 in the Recording section of the Advanced tab in the Settings menu. On Mac, MOV may be more compatible than MP4. Both MKV and MOV support recording multiple audio tracks. If you need more details about file formats, you can check out the Choosing the Best File Format lesson in the course playlist. Speaking of multiple audio tracks, select the tracks you want to record below the recording format. I normally just leave them all checked and ditch the ones I don't need in editing. If you need more information on setting up multiple audio tracks, check out the Basic Audio Settings lesson in the course playlist. The next setting is a big decision for some users, choosing your encoder. For advanced users or users with more powerful hardware configurations, choosing the right encoder can improve your performance and quality. If you're setting up a profile that you also want to use for streaming and you just want an exact copy of your stream, you can select UStream Encoder and you're done. OBS will know what to record. But if you want to record a copy of your stream at a higher quality or the profile is exclusively for recording, there are a few more steps. Choosing X264 will utilize the capabilities of your CPU for recording. If your computer has a dedicated graphics processor, you'll see options here to record using GPU encoding. This will be NVENC for NVIDIA cards and AMF for AMD cards. Using GPU hardware encoding utilizes the performance capabilities of your GPU and lessens the impact on your CPU. But typically, X264 looks better at lower bit rates like what you would use for streaming, and NVENC or AMF looks better at higher bit rates used for recording, although this gap has closed significantly over the years. If you want to record to a lower resolution than the resolution set in the video tab of the settings menu, you can check the rescale output and change the resolution there. Leave custom muxer settings blank unless you have a specific use case that requires it. There are a few options for rate control. This is what controls your bitrate of your recording. With streaming, using CBR or constant bitrate is recommended. With recording, you could have more flexibility depending on your hardware. In my experience, you get the best results using CBR or VBR. VBR is variable bitrate. It changes the bitrate being used based on the amount of action in the scene being output. This can improve quality, but causes issues if your CPU or GPU can't keep up with the changes. On the flip side of this, CBR can give a more consistent performance, but some scenes will suffer degraded quality if there is too much action in the scene. Another option available, if you're encoding with X264, is constant rate factor, or CRF. With CRF, you set a level of quality and the encoder tries to maintain that level throughout the recording. This can result in higher quality recordings, but also much larger file sizes, as well as a higher performance impact on your system. Generally, CRF 23 to 20 is a good balance of quality to file size and performance. The lower the number, the higher the quality end result, so you could go lower than 20 if your system can handle it. If you're using your GPU to encode, I highly recommend just using VBR to record. Let's cover a couple more settings before we get into setting our bitrate. The keyframe interval controls how often a keyframe is created in the video. For example, if your interval is set to every 2 seconds and your frame rate is 30 frames per second, this would mean roughly every 60 frames a keyframe is produced. Keyframe interval should be set to 2 for streaming generally. For recording, I set my keyframe interval to 5. If your hardware is struggling with the encoding process, you can raise the preset, which will use fewer resources and result in a smoother recording process, but it will also lower the quality of your recordings. Now we can get into the behemoth that is bitrate. With streaming, the main limiting factor is going to be the upload capability of your internet connection. With recording, there are a few factors: the type of hard drive you're using, the supported bitrate of your recording device, and a few others. But it's not as intricate as it may seem at first glance. A good starting point is YouTube's recommended upload bitrates. For 1080p, YouTube recommends between 8 to 15 megabits per second, depending on your frame rate. For 4K, that goes up to 35 to 68 megabits per second. Note that this is the bitrate you want to upload your final videos. Generally speaking, you want to record at a higher bitrate than you render your final videos. You can always compress more during editing, but you can't add quality to a recording it didn't have. The next factor you have to consider is how long you'll be recording. My profile for 4K recording uses a fairly large bitrate. When I'm live streaming, I can't record hours-long videos at that bitrate. It would result in files hundreds of gigabytes in size. So I lower my stream recording profile to about a third of my recording profile's bitrate. This allows me to maintain a good balance of quality and file size for my stream VODs that are still better quality than the original stream. The last thing to consider is where you are recording your files to. If you are using a mechanical hard drive or using your main drive to record to, that could bottleneck your system and limit how high of a bitrate you can use. For 720p or lower, I recommend 8 to 10 megabits per second. For 1080p, 25 to 40 megabits per second. For 1440p, 45 to 60. For 4K, I would suggest 50 megabits per second at minimum, but 100 megabits or higher if your system can handle it. For exclusively recording profiles, make sure your audio bitrate is set to 320. Audio quality is more important than video quality, so there's no reason to record at a lower bitrate. As always, make sure you do multiple test recordings as you change settings. Setting up for recording is a lengthy process that consists of a lot of trial and error, but there's no reason it should feel intimidating. If you want to learn even more about OBS Studio and how to use it, check out this video. And if you want to see the lessons from this course in action, come give me a follow on Twitch and say hi in chat. Remember, streaming is supposed to be fun. I'll see you next time.